my writing, I've always really wanted to tackle Italy, but it's so hard to do so in a not cliched way. So I was trying to rack my brain about what was the weirdest thing that had ever happened to me in Italy, or what was the least cliche thing I could think of. And it was when I visited this museum, the Keats Shelley Museum, and I saw Shelley's ponytail. So a dead guy's ponytail was the, I guess, the motivation behind the story. The protagonist is a grad student poet. She, on a whim, decides to go on a trip to Rome, and she kind of comes upon this ponytail, and it unravels a lot of the issues about her father and his death, and her avoiding her academic career at this point, and her identity. And I won't give away the ending, but hair figures a lot, or lack of hair, or what you do to hair, and how that can become a crisis.
I thought it would be nice to, as a base for the story, embed or include human hair into the pages itself. I love working with materials as a visual artist, and letting materials help to tell a story or create a narrative. But working with the hair was kind of disgusting also, because it was all different colors and all different lengths and textures, and then you put it into this wet mass. It almost was like it was alive in some way. It was reanimated. I liked how the end result turned out, because it looked like it had this white background of pulp with this strands of hair randomly through it. But from a distance, it actually kind of imitated the look of marble.
We chatted about this idea that she had early on, and I was like, that's such an amazing idea. Let's make paper out of hair. That's great. But when hair is an abstract concept, I think it denotes something entirely different than if you're touching hair. So once you start to touch this paper or look at this paper, like, there's a revulsion that comes with it. So you're attracted to it, but you're also repulsed. It was interesting to see, a 5,000 word short story distilled down into like 12 phrases or 12, little bits of text. And to see, if someone's coming to the artist book as the first read, what kind of experience will they have of the story? What will they think the story is about, even? It feels really good to have someone respond to your work. So it's like, what did you think of my story? And what were the most interesting parts to you? Please do tell. So in that way, it was really fun for me to see how someone else interprets my work, and what other art they can create out of that art as well.
I feel like it worked really well as a collaborative duo. We did collaborate again on another artist book that I wrote a grant for after, and Caitlynn wrote another piece for me. The artist book looks very different than the one from this project, but because it worked so well in terms of our communication, it was very fulfilling in that way.